I am Bill Courtwright with Living Right with Bill Courtwright, and this is the Stress Mastery Podcast, where we take you from the science to the spirituality of stress mastery.
Hello, and welcome back to another episode here at the Stress Mastery Podcast. I am your host, Mark Mittlesteadt. This week, our topic is labeling. And on today's episode of the Stress Mastery Podcast Weekend Edition, we're going to discuss truth in labeling. In 1967, the government enacted the Fair Packaging and Labeling Act, directing the Federal Trade Commission and the Food and Drug Administration to issue regulations requiring that all consumer commodities be labeled to disclose net contents, identity of commodity, and the name and place of business of the product's manufacturer, packer, or distributor. The regulations were necessary to prevent consumer deception or to facilitate value comparisons. Of course, many companies wanted to get around this labeling in an attempt to deceive the public in order to maximize profit. I can give you one example out of thousands of similar deceptions. The Labeling Act was supposed to prevent, but was easily manipulated. In our food supply, there is an ingredient called MSG, or monosodium glutamate. Now, monosodium glutamate, MSG, is a flavor enhancer commonly added to Chinese food, canned vegetables, soups, processed meats, and a wide variety of packaged foods. The Food and Drug Administration has classified MSG as a food ingredient that's generally recognized as safe, but its use remains controversial. For this reason, when MSG is added to the food, the FDA requires that it be listed on the label. Many people suffer adverse reactions to foods containing MSG. These reactions, known as MSG symptom complex, include headaches, flushing, sweating, facial pressure or tightness, numbness, tingling or burning in the face, neck, and other areas, rapid fluttering heartbeats or heart palpitations, chest pain, and nausea, among others. So why, when any or all of these symptoms can occur, are companies putting this in our food? Because MSG is used to intensify the natural flavor of certain foods. It literally tricks the brain into believing there is more flavor in your food than would otherwise be there. Without it, the food producers need to add more ingredients to the food, which costs them more money, which cuts into their profit margins. Now, the truth in labeling requires these companies to list this ingredient in the food they produce, so those who suffer from consuming it are made aware, so they can choose to avoid it. But here's the kicker. Food companies get around the labeling law by simply changing the name to something else, leaving the consumer none the wiser. They also call MSG autolyzed plant protein, glutamic acid, autolyzed yeast extract, hydrolyzed plant protein, sodium caseinate, calcium caseinate, hydrolyzed vegetable protein, textured protein, monopotassium glutamate, and others. There are so many different names that MSG is called on the food label. Now, you might be wondering what this all has to do with personal or spiritual growth. Well, I'm going to tell you. From the moment of our birth, we have an awful lot of labels given to us that we have no choice but to live with. We're a baby, an infant, a toddler, a child, a boy or a girl, a son or daughter, niece or nephew, grandchild, and we're also labeled as cute, sweet, precious, innocent, and so on. But sometimes we're also given other labels, like ugly, chubby, a crier, difficult, and even a born sinner, and many others. We've been given all these labels, and our life has just begun. As we grow up and become programmed, the labels keep coming, many of which keep with us our entire life, and sometimes eventually becoming our identity. We can have labels given to us or even create our own, like beautiful, generous, giving, compassionate, friendly, capable, intelligent, smart, strong, brave, etc. But there are other labels that can be detrimental to our well-being, and if we believe in them strongly enough, we can suffer with them throughout our entire life, convinced that this is who we are. Labels like fat, ugly, lazy, troublemaker, loser, stupid, ignorant, weak, hopeless, selfish, unworthy, poor. All these labels we grow up with and live with are the human equivalent of MSG in food, poisoning our minds with faulty ideas about who we are and what we should be or what we could become. The question we must ask ourselves is this: is there any truth in this labeling, or are we deceiving ourselves with them? These labels are nothing but judgments, either judgment from others or of ourselves, and like our beliefs, none of them may even be true. But also like beliefs, we can hold on to these faulty labels and allow them to undermine or sabotage our life. Our ego loves to play mind games with us. And just like food producers will change the words in an attempt to deceive us, our ego constantly uses the same practice, always deceiving us in order to keep our faulty belief system intact, even when it's unhealthy for us to do so. While labels are descriptive, they can also be powerfully convincing. The depth of our belief in them, as applied to ourselves, can be anywhere from slightly problematic to dangerous. Think of labels like fat or ugly, stupid or lazy, that can be very harmful to our well-being when we believe them to be true. To ones we may identify ourselves with, such as an addict or a victim, that can be extremely dangerous if we continue to perpetuate and believe them. Now, obviously, we need words to communicate with each other, and many believe we shouldn't be so sensitive to what others say to us or about us or what labels they call us. And to a large part, I agree, because nothing anyone says to us or about us is really never about us. It says more about them than it does about us. It's always about how they see themselves. Don Miguel Ruiz, in his book, The Four Agreements, advises us to be impeccable with our word. to speak with integrity, to say only what we mean. Avoid using the word to speak against ourselves or to gossip about others. To use the power of our word in the direction of truth and love. Words can heal, but they can also hurt. Words are thoughts expressed. So what do they say about someone who uses labels and throws them at people with the intention of insulting or hurting them? What does it say about people who use labels without any understanding of the meaning behind them? You can completely alter another's life with something as simple as a label. You can uplift someone by labeling them smart or funny, beautiful, or limitless. But you can just as easily crush someone's spirit by calling them stupid or lazy, ugly or hopeless. It depends on what they already believe about themselves. Someone who is strong in spirit wouldn't even care what labels people use to describe them. But someone who is already suffering or doubting themselves or feeling depressed may only need to hear one more negative word that adds to a long list of negative labels they already believe about themselves that can push them over the edge. Such is the power of a label. Why do we believe in the labels other people give us? Don't we know ourselves enough to not be concerned with what others think? Well, it's been programmed into us to believe these labels ever since we were born. And they don't even have to be true for us to believe them. When I studied psychology, I found all these disorders found in the psychiatric Bible, the DSM-5, to be rather disturbing because all a therapist has to do is tell their patient that they are something. For example, bipolar. And from then on, their patient will believe that they are, in fact, bipolar. It then is no longer a symptom they might suffer with or possibly be able to overcome. This is who they are now. Then the patient goes on believing that they are bipolar. I've had a few clients who actually say this is who they are. Well, I'm bipolar. As if it were their first name. And they say it rather emphatically. And for no reason other than someone they trusted labeled them with it. And after working with them for a while, I've come to find out the only reason they believe they're bipolar is because they were told they were. And the only reason they were told that is because the label was the only way insurance would cover their therapy. But this is the nature and danger of labels. We can easily get sucked into believing these labels are true. Then we go around believing we are these labels, and we perpetuate them by affirming them everywhere we go. I am bipolar. I am an addict. I am unhappy. I am sick. I am depressed. I am unemployable, unworthy, ugly, fat, lazy, and on and on. It gets to the point where these words are no longer labels, but possibly our identity, or who we think we are. And the more we believe this is who we are, the less likely we are to change our perception of who we think we are. Yet, who we believe we are is at the core of how we live our life. Remember, beliefs are nothing but a collection of thoughts we hold to be true, even when they aren't true. Labels are no different. We can believe they are true so convinced we are this or that label. But again, labels are limiting. Suppose you have the label of bipolar. Instead of working to find the root cause of your manic depressive symptoms, you may just assume you are bipolar and then believe you always will be simply because you were given that label. And then you spend the rest of your life worried about when your manic depression will flare up, not because you suffer with those symptoms, but you believe you are bipolar. This will always keep you trapped in the identity of being bipolar and potentially sabotage your life. But maybe instead, you've been labeled with having anxiety. Then, every time you feel anxiety, instead of working to overcome it, you accept it and believe in that label so strongly, you just keep feeling anxiety in every situation as if there were nothing you could do about it. Or worse, you've been told the only way you can deal with it is by using drugs. These labels are often used as crutches or excuses for how we act or deal with life. You may tell others who ask you to do something like go out for some fun that normally makes you feel an anxiety or even a panic attack. And then your stock reply is, "Oh, I can't go. I have anxiety." We all need to label things, including ourselves, in order to communicate with each other. But we should not allow labels to limit our thinking to a very narrow definition where it can mean nothing else. To do so is to have a closed mind. We cannot grow unless we are willing to be open-minded and consider alternate or different ideas. Clinging to narrowly defined labels can undermine expansion. So when I say, "I am God experiencing myself," instead of getting hung up on labels, I could also mean, "I am the consciousness of the universe." Or maybe I mean, "I'm the flying spaghetti monster." Or maybe I just mean, "me." And whatever that label means. Don't allow labels to define who you are or how they can control your life. That's it for today's show. Our mission here is to create a shift in the planet. You can join us on this mission by clicking like, share, and subscribe. The links are right below the show notes. As always, until next time, stay inspired.